today on Las Vegas Now.
Come on in. That's what the T-Mobile Arena is telling Vegas Golden Knights fans. And they have a surprise.
Everything's just kind of this blur, you know? Until you hit rock bottom.
The unauthorized biopic of Vegas headliner Britney Spears premieres on Lifetime, and people are going crazy on social media what fans and stars are saying about the movie.
And from your living room to the stratosphere to downtown, we have plenty of ways to get moving on this motivational Monday.
You are watching Las Vegas Now with Lindsey Simon, Kendall Tenney, and Mercedes Martinez.
Welcome, welcome to Las Vegas Now. I'm Kendall Tenney.
And I'm Lindsey Simon. Hopefully you were able to stay dry this weekend and avoid the I-15 traffic nightmare. Someone who ended up getting stuck was actually R. Kelly. The R&B singer posted this video on Instagram to let his fans know what was going on.
Yo, what's up, Vegas? It's your boy Kills, man. I'm just disappointed right now. I'm on my way to Vegas to do a show tonight. But due to all of this heavy traffic, as y'all can see, man, it's crazy. Look at this. Both ways, it's crazy. But we are going to get there, but we might not get there till around 11:30. So I hope you guys, you know, love me enough to wait.
Well, he didn't make it in time and the show had to be canceled, but he did end up going to the Hard Rock to meet with fans and talk with them. So later, R. Kelly posted a fan's heartfelt tweet. He also responded, "It's not about what you can't control, it's about what you can. Hashtag showed up because I care. Hashtag spent 4 hours with fans." At least he, you know, came, and there's not much you can do with
he
traffic.
He did what he could. Yeah, the traffic was really bad all weekend between here and Southern California with all the rain coming through.
Yeah. Well, he showed up, so what
else?
And didn't you have, you were traveling this weekend.
I was traveling this weekend and almost got arrested as a result of this storm. And here's the story. We're traveling with friends to Southern California, stopped in Ventura because a road was closed because of a mudslide.
Mm-hmm.
Stopped at Denny's, had dinner at Denny's, left. The next morning, we realized we had not paid for our meal.
So,
yeah,
you just dined and dashed.
We thought we were wanted now in Southern California. So we go back to the Denny's, confess our crime, find the server, pay her back. But it was,
Was she mad?
No, she was actually very sweet about it. She said we looked like really nice people until we weren't.
And Until you totally gypped me.
Exactly, exactly.
All right, well, good for you for going
back. They forgave us. Some Lifetime Network fans aren't pleased with the latest biopic on that network. This Saturday, Britney Ever After. Did you watch this?
I saw parts of it. I couldn't watch the whole thing because it was horrendous.
Okay, I've heard it was terrible. It aired on Lifetime, and a lot of people said it was toxic, if you're playing on the Britney song there. The pop star was played by Natasha Bassett, and a lot of people said it was a low blow because Britney Spears never even authorized this film. Celebs like Snooki and Sarah Michelle Gellar took to social media, calling out Lifetime. Others said it was full of errors, such as horrible costume interpretations and a non-existent sex tape.
Yeah, between her and JT. And Sarah Michelle Gellar, there's one part in the movie when they're like, "Oh, so cool that we got to hang out with Buffy tonight." She's like, "I don't know if they were talking about this Buffy, but like, we did not hang out." And she had a lot to say on social media. I mean, she was constantly tweeting about it. It was bad.
Well, and they couldn't even use her music, right?
No, they couldn't use her music because obviously licensing issues. So I think they used Satisfaction, which was a Rolling Stones song that she covered. And then her song from Crossroads, which was, you know, from a soundtrack. So that's where they got
It sounds like it was cheesy.
Yeah.
But they're getting a lot
Britney
of attention.
Britney doesn't care. She posted a picture on Instagram, like, basically topless. I love when she does that. Like,
good for Britney.
Just try and get them out. Okay. Well, today is National Love Your Pet Day, so we wanted to show off your fur babies. Debbie posted this picture of her dog, Cody, laying with her, what is this, a Great Dane?
It's a great nephew. Oh, and a great nephew. Okay.
And here's Blue, the cat Miriam rescued 7 years ago. Whoa, big cat.
Yeah, that is a big cat. Debbie shared this photo of her best friend, Boo Boo. And Jillian showed off Monty, who she rescued 13 years ago. And let's take a look at these cuties. Waiting, our executive producers, Pooches, Bosco and
there
Abby,
they
there
are.
They are. And of course, not all four-legged friends are cats and dogs. Here's Rachel with her horse, Lyric. This was taken just a few weeks ago.
Aw, and here's Walden the bunny, who was rescued by Julie. I love all these rescues.
Mm-hmm.
A tortoise or a turtle named Mr. Big. We couldn't leave out 8 News Now anchor Christiane Klein's entire zoo family, which includes a dog, a cat, and a desert tortoise named Sheldon. Very cute. Thanks
and
for showing those pictures.
Take a look at this. This is Buster, our dog, along with Savannah, my daughter.
Oh.
Buster is a Bichon poodle mix who we kind of accidentally adopted years ago. A long story. We were supposed to be babysitting for a year, but he ended up becoming part of the family.
Well, that's how it works.
Yeah, exactly. The average American has at least one pet. You do not right now, right? You do not have a pet?
We're living with our in-laws right now, so I have claimed the 2 Dobermans.
Okay, all right. So, and get this, as Americans, we spend more than $60 billion annually on our pets.
I believe it. It's a booming business.
It is big.
All right, now we're going to check in with Tedd Florendo with a look at our weather. Hey, Tedd.
Hey, guys, can't forget my 2 dogs. I've got a golden retriever, Bruner, and a beagle named Woofy, who I can deal without his bark, that's for sure. But we'll show you the pictures of my little pet family coming up later on our newscast. Weather alerts, we got 2 of them to talk about after. Hey, great rain we saw this weekend, right? The winds now picking up, the rain over and done with, at least for now. Your gusts up to 40 to 50 possible tomorrow in these specific areas. We have a wind advisory that goes into effect at 10 a.m. and lasts through 7 p.m. tomorrow. The Las Vegas Valley is not included in that wind advisory. Current conditions outside, most specifically we want to show you the wind speeds where we've got winds really gusting up there. From Las Vegas to Henderson to North Las Vegas, even up to Aliante and out towards Nellis. Your evening planner stays nice and cool to the 60s, even closer to 60, 11 o'clock. Notice those winds. We retain some winds early on. Then light breezes late night tonight. Mostly cloudy tomorrow. Your morning start for your morning commute just right around 60 degrees with breezy winds expected as early as midday tomorrow. That is your weather update. Let's get a check of those weather headlines with our very own Christiane Klein.
Thanks,
hi, Christiane.
Well, as those temperatures continue to climb around the valley and in the mountains, big danger lingers for avalanches. Mount Charleston just experienced one of their biggest avalanches since 2010. How it happened this past weekend, stopping just a few yards from one neighborhood in Kyle Canyon. And that's where we find our own Katie Bohr, who went up to the mountain today. Katie, have there been any evacuations?
Christiane, no voluntary or mandatory evacuations here just yet, but the officials that were out here assessing the situation yesterday are still taking this situation very seriously. We're in the Echo neighborhood, the main road leading up here. Echo Road actually closed to the public for concern of more avalanches, but check it out. You can see just behind me where that avalanche actually occurred, right in the mountainside right out there. Now, Mount Charleston Fire Protection District told us today that they believe this slide started at the top of the South Loop Trailhead by the Cathedral Picnic area. Now, it traveled about 3,000 to 4,000 feet down the mountain before stopping just about 200 yards behind the homes in the Rainbow subdivision below. Now, I spoke to the fire captain, Steve Clement, earlier. He was out there assessing the situation with emergency managers as well as the Forest Service, and they were making sure no hikers were trapped out there when the slide happened on Saturday. He estimated, get this, that slide left behind debris at least 30 to 40 feet high and 150 feet wide. So a very expansive area. Of course, back live, we're going to be talking more at 5 and 6 o'clock with him, the fire captain, as well as residents that live here in this Echo as well as Rainbow neighborhood. Reporting live from Mount Charleston, Katie Bohr. I'll send it back inside to you.
That is incredible. Thanks, Katie. Well, emergency repairs continue today on southbound I-15 after a massive storm washed out part of the highway. Now, this happened near Cajon Pass and State Route 138 Friday in California. Right now, 4 lanes are open, but we are told they are really narrow while crews work to repair that damaged area. Construction, guys, is expected to last for at least 4 weeks. And a reminder, if you are heading to Southern California right now, you're going to have a little bit of a delay, about a 10-mile backup down at the Nevada-California state line.
Yeah, driving back today, a lot of traffic, especially heading the other direction.
You almost didn't make it.
I barely made it today.
If I had to go solo today,
exactly.
Would have not.
Yeah,
still have a few more weeks, too.
Thanks, Christiane.
Well, hockey fans are getting a chance to explore the rink at T-Mobile. If you're looking for tickets to their very first game, stick around. We're going to tell you how you can get them.
And Snapchat without your phone. The stylish Snapchat spectacles that are changing up the way people are taking those 10-second videos.
CBS News, real news. I just picked up the cake for the baby shower.
Yay! You know she's having a boy, right?
But she's naming her Taylor.
She's naming him Taylor.
Oh, boy.
Buick now has an SUV for that. Introducing the new Buick Encore.
I knew I could stock. See your Southern Nevada Chevy dealers.
From esports to arm wrestling.
Are you trying?
Casinos are shaking up the gaming industry. Paul Johnsich takes a look at what they're doing to attract the next generation of gamblers.
We need to change if we want to remain relevant.
Tonight on 8 News Now at 11.
Man, so many people are fired up. The Vegas Golden Knights are hosting an open house at T-Mobile Arena. And every hour, you're going to be giving away tickets to the inaugural home game for the Vegas Golden Knights. Nami Abuzaid is with the Golden Knights, joins us to talk about this exciting event that's going to be taking place tomorrow, correct?
Yep, starting tomorrow morning.
You've got a lot of people. Anybody can come, right?
Open house to the city and to the fans. And we're opening up our 11 and 22 game ticket packages, which is a flexible and more convenient option for a lot of people. So we're excited. This is monumental.
And it's a big deal because there really aren't that many seats left. You sold 12,000 season tickets, is that right?
We've got a lot of fully paid and people on payment plans. There's limited full season tickets available, and now these 11 and 22 game packs are a new product option for them. But yeah, we're going to cut them off at a certain point, and then we're just going to sell the rest as single days and corporate and group seats. But this is your great opportunity to get in.
Yeah, because there are 40 some odd games, is that correct, home games?
Yep, 41 plus 3 preseason, so about 44. Yeah.
So most people are not going to go see all 41 games, and this is a great alternative, 11, 22 games.
Absolutely.
A chance to do that. Mm-hmm. What's the reaction been in the community as you've been part of this now when people talk about the Vegas Golden Knights?
It's been great. I mean, the grassroots support, Eve, just on tickets alone, it's local demand. It's individuals and families. It's not necessarily blocks bought up by corporations. So it's real people. It's real families. People want to pass on the sport of hockey. A lot of transplants who grew up in colder climates like myself in Boston, we grew up with hockey. And so now we want to pass it on to our children. So there's a lot of those pass it on type relationships of people buying, but also the fact that they're born and raised local are so happy that there's a pro sports team to root for.
Well, and there are so many transplants here. I grew up in Texas, so hockey was not a big thing when I was growing up. Mm-hmm. But obviously, if you're from the East Coast, huge deal. Yeah. So many people have been dying for this to come to Las Vegas, mm-hmm. and that is part of the excitement.
Absolutely. But a lot of born and raised locals who have not been to a lot of hockey games just stepped up and supported us because we're the first pro sports team in town. And so they're so excited to have a homegrown team to root for. So we're grateful to them. And really, as our owner loves to say, he said, we asked you to put deposits down on a team that didn't exist in an arena that wasn't yet built.
Right.
And the people of Vegas stepped up. So we're very grateful for that support.
There is definitely an appetite for it. Nami Abuzaid, thank you so much for joining us.
Awesome.
Check out the open house tomorrow at T-Mobile Arena starting at 8. And it goes until 8 Wednesday, so it's 24 hours.
24 straight hours. For all the people in the industry, the casino industry, may work 3 shifts. There's an opportunity for everyone to come down.
And free tickets given away every hour, is that right?
Yeah, pair of tickets, 24 times 2, 48 tickets given away to our historic home opener. We'll be the 31st team in the 100th season of the NHL.
Wow.
So it'll be fantastic.
Well, congratulations on everything already.
Thank you.
All right, Lindsey.
Well, it's the kindergarten question that can actually reveal a lot about your personality. Find out what your favorite color says about you, plus how you can add color into your workout. We'll explain next. But first, here's today's trivia. On this day in 1980, this band won 2 Grammys, one for Record of the Year and another for Song of the Year. Figure it out? We've got the answer next.
The Spring Home Expo is back at Cashman Center this weekend. See home improvement ideas and products for inside and outside your home. It's all here. Seniors free Friday. Military and children free all weekend. Doors open noon Friday. Sponsored by the RJ.
Why do we strive? Why do we push?
Spring Home Expo is back at Cashman Center this weekend. See home improvement ideas and products for inside and outside your home. It's all here. Seniors free Friday. Military and children free all weekend. Doors open noon Friday. Sponsored by the RJ.
And welcome back. Before the break, we asked, on this day in 1980, this band won two Grammys, one for Record of the Year and another for Song of the Year. Did you guess it? It was the Doobie Brothers. They won for their hit, What a Fool Believes. A recent report says your favorite color can say a lot about you and your personality. The folks at ThoughtCatalog.com say, for instance, if your favorite color is blue, you are a deep and calm person. But you have a stormy side. That would be Lindsey. Favorite color is blue. Mine too. Mine too for that runner. All right, so those who love green are practical, they say, well-balanced and generous. I don't know how they come up with this information. People who love the color black, they say, want power and prestige. And those who like white are simple, neat, and optimistic. Speaking of colors, Lindsey has an array of colors to talk about.
Yeah, we do. They call it one of the happiest and brightest 5Ks on the planet. The Color Run makes a stop here in Las Vegas this weekend, all to benefit Three Square Food Bank, and Alexis Mers is here with more. Thanks for joining us.
You're welcome. Thanks for having me.
So this is fun. It takes a lot for me to, like, get up off the couch and run, but this is one that I'd actually like to participate in.
Yeah, it's very colorful. It's a lot of fun, and the best thing about it is it's not very competitive, so you can run, skip, jog, crawl, dance, whatever your heart desires. Anyone can have a good time, friends, family, and it's all for a good cause.
And this is for Three Square Food Bank.
Three Square Food Bank.
So can you tell people a little bit about, you know,
Absolutely.
What you all do?
Absolutely. So you're literally stepping into a dream, but for some people, the reality is facing hunger. Right. So 1 in 7 people in our own city don't know where their next meal is coming from.
Okay, so tickets to this help benefit that?
Yes, absolutely.
That's a great cause.
So through the partnership over the last 5 years, this will be the 6th year for the Color Run. Spend nearly $35,000, which puts back 100,000 meals wow. for hungry men, women, children all around Southern Nevada.
So how does it work? People are running and other people are just chucking, like, colored chalk
yeah,
at them? Is that over?
Exactly. So you're stepping into the Dream Tour. It's all about unicorns. You have these cute little unicorns here, colors in all of the zones, vibrant music across. Yeah, we do have some color. I actually have a shirt for you. Put this on and let's get a little colorful.
Woo!
This year there'll be an all new dream wall, so you can actually spray paint your wildest dreams, any of your inspiration on the wall for everyone to see.
Oh.
There'll be a foam zone, so yeah, of course there's color, but there's also gonna be like foamy clouds, so it'll be a lot of fun. Really messy, but I promise everything comes out. It's not permanent.
Oh, okay. So people are, I'm running.
Yeah, so is it okay if I throw it on you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm
so
running.
This is real color. It's not just for TV, and it's like, woo!
And we're raising money.
And we're raising money.
And it's for a good cause.
Yes.
And it all comes out. Oh, that's
so
pretty.
We're fighting hunger, and we're walking into a dream all at the same time.
It's all about having fun.
I mean, and look at these unicorns.
And this all comes in your pack that you get.
So you don't get the unicorn, but you will get to take a picture with the runicorn that'll be
okay.
there. So there'll be a lot of fun, giant unicorns all over the place. You do get a unicorn medal.
Okay.
Because everyone gets the medal just for finishing.
Okay. This could all
and you
be yours.
Get your, all yours.
All right, guys.
If you sign up, and you can actually sign up until the day of the event on Saturday.
Okay.
So you still have time. And if you use the promo code, you get $5 off if you use 3Square.
All right. Again, the Color Run Dream Tour this Saturday, February 25th. Kicking Yay. Off at 8 a.m. Tickets are between $39.99 and $44.99 for team members and individual color runners.
Yes.
Kendall.
Good stuff. Thank you for being a friend. That's the motto of a new restaurant catering to Golden Girls fans, where you might want to go for your next trip to try it out.
Traffic Now is sponsored by Ed Bernstein and Associates. Enough said, call Ed.
President's Day specials are happening now at Furniture Fashions. Save 20-7
only on 8 News Now.
Welcome back, everyone. We're taking a look at what's trending now, starting with some social media spectacles. Snapchat is now selling these glasses online for around $130. The glasses let you film snaps with the touch of a button. Once you're done, it's saved to your Snapchat app. where you can later edit and share it from your smartphone. Seems like a lot of work. The glasses first came out back in November, but were only available in vending machines called Snapbots. Now, while Snapchat isn't making any money from the spectacles, they plan to make a Wall Street trading debut next month. Do you Snapchat, Kendall?
Oh, okay, don't even pretend now that...
I don't even know if you know what it is.
During the break, yes, she turns to me, Lindsey turns to me and says, do you know what Snapchat is?
Like a bless your heart
moment. Yeah, exactly. Now, that's the thing they have on social media. Okay, you and I both love this next thing, right?
Yeah.
The Golden Girls, by the way, I've never used Snapchat.
Thanks a thing.
The Golden Girls fans have something to look forward to. Plans to visit to New York might be in order if you're a huge Golden Girls fan. And yes, Lindsey and I both like the Golden Girls. A cafe is now open in honor of Rue McClanahan from the 1980s sitcom. You may remember she played the saucy Southern belle Blanche Devereaux on the show. Rue La Rue Cafe is decorated with lots of unique memorabilia from the late performer's estate.
I'm definitely going to
thank
check
you
that
for
out.
Being a friend.
Thank you for being a friend. I bet Betty White Snapchats.
Yes.
I'm gonna see if she does. I'm gonna follow her. Well, with every new season, we can always look forward to new edition of M&M's, whether it's green and red for Christmas, pink, red, and white for Valentine's Day, and now, thanks to a recent leak, a sweet leak, if you will. We now know what the candy company is up to for Easter. Are you ready? It's vanilla cupcake M&Ms. Mm. The candies will have a white chocolate base and will be coated with pastel-colored candy shells. Now, M&M's last flavor launch was a bust. It was like a white cheesecake.
Yeah.
And everyone's like, it just tastes like regular milk chocolate M&Ms.
Yeah, even that didn't like get me really excited. I love M&Ms.
But... we're gonna have to do a taste test.
Yes.
Maybe we can get a hold of them before they...
we could sample.
I think they're being sold at Target exclusively, so we'll have to get a sample of it. Well, remember the cronut craze? People would make lines around the block for a taste of the croissant donut pastry. Then there was the health nut kale craze.
That's still going on.
Avocado toast is all over my Instagram feed.
Yeah, it seems like every year, cars, clothes, and hairstyles are not the only things that go in and out of style. Yeah. Jessica Sanchez explains the hot new foods you might be eating this year.
Move over, kale. There's a new superfood that's making waves. Leaves contain high levels of calcium, potassium, and protein, as well as vitamins A, B, C, D, and E. The leaves can be eaten fresh, cooked, or dried without losing their nutritional content. Moringa trees are grown in Haiti, parts of Latin America, and in Africa. It's currently being sold in the U.S. as a powder and in energy shots. It can also be found in bars and teas. Looking for an alternative to tofu? Try jackfruit. This large fruit with a spiky outer shell is mostly grown in South America and Southeast Asia. When raw, the inner flesh is pear-like, but when cooked, it develops a savory flavor. The meaty texture of jackfruit has the ability to absorb the flavors in which it's cooked, making it the perfect ingredient to make a fake pulled pork sandwich. And soda sales fell for the 11th year in a row, while coconut water sales rose 27%. The rise of coconut water brings other plant-based waters to the market, such as maple water or cactus water. You may be finding these natural beverages hitting your grocery store shelves very soon. I'm Jessica Sanchez reporting.
Well, speaking of food, they are an ocean delicacy and some say an aphrodisiac. We're talking about oysters.
I want to talk about oysters.
So what is the right way to open oysters? And can we really find a pearl? We're going to look into that.
Furniture for Las Vegas Now, provided by Walker Furniture.
Temps heading towards the weekend. In your Weather Now forecast, tomorrow on Good Day.
You are watching Las Vegas Now with Lindsey Simon, Kendall Tenney, and Mercedes Martinez.
Some people like them raw with a little bit of Tabasco and horseradish. Others eat them deep fried. We're talking oysters, people.
Executive Chef Bradley Manchester from Hard Rock Hotel's newest restaurant, Oyster Bar, is here with the right way to pick out an oyster and something neither of us has ever done, how to shuck an oyster.
Shuck oysters, that's right.
So first, how do we pick them out? How do we know what's a good oyster?
Well, usually you have your East Coast and your West Coast oysters. Those are going to be your most popular varieties.
Yeah, and they clash, too.
Exactly.
They do not get along.
And usually people that are East Coast are not fan of West Coast. But what I find the difference is that the East Coast, coming from a little bit more colder waters, are going to be a little bit more saltier, a little bit more brinier, versus the West Coast are going to be a little bit more sweeter, kind of have almost like a cucumber flavor. A lot of times they're a little bit smaller of an oyster. But again, it's what you like, and I can tell you, from being at the Oyster Bar, our opening date was February 5th. We've had people from both walks, and they're very specific on what kind of oysters they enjoy.
And what's your preference?
I actually like the West Coast. I like the sweetness of it. I like the cucumberness of it, and I just like that type of oyster.
Are you an oyster fan?
I've had one oyster one time.
Yeah.
It was a year ago at Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
But I'm ready to try it again.
Awesome.
But how do we do you have to shuck them yourself at restaurants?
We do. We shuck them to order. We don't pre-shuck any oysters or anything.
The customer does not have to shuck them. We shuck them for them.
But like I said, the kitchen's all open there, so they can see us shucking.
Okay.
And what you do, it's actually, just like anything else, it's better with repetition.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Right.
So what you're going to do is, I have a towel here. Lay your oyster down on your towel. And take this other towel we have folded, put it right on top. Now, you guys are gonna see the oyster kind of come to a point, and that's what we call like the hinge of the oyster.
Okay.
All right, and you're gonna take your oyster knife that has a little bit of a point sticking up, put it right inside there, and you should just be able to pop it.
I broke part of the shell.
Yeah, just be careful with your hand there.
Okay.
I wish I had ketchup packets to accidentally
fake it. And
like,
then that pops right off.
Yeah, pops right off.
Like I said,
it definitely comes better with repetition.
Okay, I got some off.
Mine's
very messy.
Okay.
Done. Done.
Well, that's a wrap. Thanks for joining us. This is fun.
So, but that's how you shuck an oyster. And then underneath the oyster, there's going to be a muscle that actually holds the oyster on. And what we do is just take the oyster knife, flip it over, and then you have an oyster that's ready to serve.
Oh, you don't eat it straight. Oh, you just.
Yeah, you have it ready to serve.
You're undoing it from the shell.
You want to take it and undo it from the shell.
So I hear the Magic Mike show, which, Kendall, you can't wait for, opening up next month.
Yeah, it's scheduled to open on March 30th.
And you're right next door.
Yeah, we are right next door to it.
Yeah.
So
the aphrodisiac thing, the Magic Mike, might tie in there.
Might play into one another.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Sounds like a
But no, we're very excited about the Oyster Bar. Like I said, it's a more of a contemporary style menu than you'll find at some of the classic oyster bars. But we definitely have a lot of the classic dishes, but some new things as well.
If someone's not a fan of oysters, they're still
we have a couple of dishes that doesn't have seafood in it as well.
Yeah.
And Rabah's and oyster bars are actually really trendy right now.
They are. I mean, we've had nothing but great response since our opening on February 5th.
Very cool. Well, thank you for joining
us.
This was fun. And thanks for, making it look like I did the right
thing. Bradley, thanks so much.
Thank you.
Well, in a great workout while helping local people in need. Up next, more on the Scale the Strat event taking place this month and tips on how to make it to the top.
Today on 8 News Now at 5, snow creating a winter playground in Mount Charleston. After an avalanche, are there still concerns? We're back on the mountain live. Plus mystery meat, why your grocery store packaging may not have all the ingredients on 8 News Now at 5. This portion of Las Vegas Now is sponsored by Burnham Construction Services.
And you can forget the stair climber at the gym. This is the ultimate workout. We are talking about 108 floors up. Pete Sable from the American Lung Association is here along with fellow climber Henry Clay with the tales of this year's Scale the Strat, where people, whoever wants to, for a good cause, can walk up the stairs all the way to the 108th floor. You guys are talking about this. You've done it six times. You've done it once, and you're getting ready for your second time.
Again.
Tell us about the event.
Yeah, so the event's great. This is Anthem's ninth year sponsoring, as you had said, my sixth time doing the climb. And I think what's so amazing about this race is that it really brings awareness to lung-related issues. And as you had said, 108 stories. Jeez. It's 1,455 stairs. But it's not as intimidating as it sounds. And what's so cool about relating it to the Lung Association is it's all about breathing.
Right. And Henry, you are with the Valley Health System, correct? Yep. You're a respiratory therapist. Mm-hmm. So it's good to have you on hand
absolutely,
at an event like this. You and your wife did it together last year.
Yes, we did. Yes, we did. So we both climbed it together. It's her first time. It's both our first times. I volunteered the year before, but the first time of climbing it. So it was an experience.
And you're going to try to go faster this year.
Yeah, I'm actually going to try to get a little better time this year. We did it about 30 minutes last year. Just kind of took our time.
You did it.
Yeah, exactly.
You do it really fast, like 13
yeah,
minutes or
I
something?
Yeah, I do. But there's a key to it, Kendall. And when you start it, for a lot of the CrossFitters and these really super athletic folks, what they end up doing is saying, hey, I'm going to start this thing out. And they just start double staring and figure they're going to start running up. They're exhausted by 20.
Yeah.
The key is to pace yourself, to monitor your breathing. And they have rest stops. And the biggest question that I normally get is, wow, did they just open the doors and have everybody run
right.
through?
Yes.
And it's not. They stagger about every 10 seconds, and the stairwell is long enough where you can stand side by side and you can pass folks if you need to.
And you, when you start off, if someone like me were walking up, I would say, I probably need an hour and a half, 2 hours. Can I say that going up, and does that matter how that you would stagger start
yeah,
time?
Yeah, it sure does. So they have elite runners that will do this in about 7 minutes. So mm-hmm. they'll go first. I know. And then as you're going through, normally they'll go in teams, and they do try to stagger it out. But you'll just say, on your left, and you can just pass over.
Well, yeah. This is, of course, to raise awareness for the American Lung Association and all sorts of respiratory ailments. How does this help with that?
It's just really great. So the way they promote it, they really promote the breathing like Pete talked about before, and anybody can do it. Our fastest climber, as you mentioned, was 7 minutes, 22 seconds. Our slowest climber, somebody's in my pulmonary rehab right now, did mm-hmm. it in about almost 2 hours. He took
wow.
his time and did it with pulmonary fibrosis at 75 years old.
That's amazing.
So, I mean, it really promotes just awareness for everybody that anybody can do this regardless of your respiratory condition, which you're...
I think this is the individual you're talking about
yeah,
right there.
Yeah, there he is. Now, Clem and Debbie Wycheki, they went out there last year. Took them about a little less than 2 hours to do it.
That's fantastic.
So anyone can actually make this climb. So it just really promotes it as a great opportunity for people to learn about breathing, learn about what the American Lung does for all the people here in the Valley and around the world, and then just really kind of a great promotion for anyone to come out and get in shape and try it out.
And Pete, what would you say to the people who are intimidated by what is obviously a daunting task, 108 stories?
Yeah, I mean, it's a great accomplishment. It's great team building. And, you know, I mean, anywhere from 7 minutes to an hour and a half, mm-hmm. I mean, you're going to get it done. And it's not a marathon. It's something that you can do at your own pace. And again, something that's really part of such a great cause like the American Lung Association.
And this has been going on for a number of years
Nine years.
9 years?
Yeah.
That's fantastic. How many people show up each year?
We get about 800.
Yeah, about 800 climbers
wow.
every year that show up, yeah. And it's just such a big community. Like, everyone cheers on everybody. Everybody kind of works together to make sure everybody makes it up to the top. So, like I said, the team building is amazing
yeah.
with this, and just the community rally support is amazing.
Yeah, that community vibe that
absolutely.
Comes with that. That kind
absolutely.
Of event's fantastic. Henry and Pete, thank you so much both
thank you.
For joining
oh, no, thank
us.
You so
good
much.
Luck this year. And if you want to get involved, scale the strat. I can't even say it, let alone climb 108 stairs. Scale the strat. Fight for Air climb is happening on February 26th. Starts at 7 in the morning, but again, you sign up
it
for
does.
Times. Is that how it works?
Yes,
absolutely.
Yeah.
And you can sign up there at scalethestrat.com. Thank you both, gentlemen, for
oh, my
being
pleasure.
With us.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Well, age means nothing when it comes to working out. See the super senior who's doing headstands and is head and shoulders above the competition. Also, a dog telling her owner to hurry up. This cute video straight ahead on Las Vegas Now.
Have you or a loved one been prescribed the antidepressant drug Abilify and later developed a compulsive gambling problem? If so, you may be entitled to compensation. In a May 2016 safety communication, the FDA...
Politely and Associates, 222-3333.
Hey everyone, welcome back. Well, age is nothing but a number, especially when it comes to fitness. This 77-year-old CrossFit extraordinaire is putting a lot of people half his age to shame. Jacinto Bonilla works out for an hour, jumping on and off a 2-foot box, doing handstand push-ups, and climbing a 15-foot rope. Bonilla says his goal is to stay out of the nursing home. He adds that his recipe for strong living is motivation, inspiration, and perspiration. Okay, so after watching that video, I think we can all agree it's time to end the excuses. Courtney Bentley, my gal pal, and the creator of the Fit and Fabulous Club, is back for this Motivational Monday with some simple moves to help tone our arms. And girl, I need help. Also, I need help with workout clothing.
No, you don't.
We need to
this
do another
is an
segment
amazing
on that.
Outfit.
Okay,
I'm
so
obsessed.
So what moves do you have for us today?
So a lot of girls, they go to the gym, they walk up, and they do a little bit of bicep curls. But the thing is you're not gonna get those shapely toned arms unless you hit the bicep in different directions. The muscle is not just a straightforward kind of thing. There's lots of complex types of things going on in there.
So and I can see yours very clearly.
You gotta make sure that we're hitting it at different types of angles.
Okay.
So I like to hit them from the side,
slightly
hit them from the front,
okay,
and hit them just slightly from the back.
Ooh.
So side, a little bit to the back,
ooh,
a little bit to the front. So that's gonna really help shape everything up. And the other thing that you want to make sure you're doing is you have your shoulders back and your abs tight. So you are working your abs even though you're not doing a traditional kind of crunch type thing.
Okay.
So we're going to pop it to the front.
All right.
Pop it to the side, a little bit to the back.
Okay.
And there we go. Now we have shapely toned arms.
Okay. All right.
So my next favorite thing to do is shaping the shoulders.
Okay.
The thing with that is that if you have strong shoulders, your waist is going to look tinier.
Yeah. Good point.
Yeah. So
optical
the stronger
illusion.
The shoulders, the smaller the waist.
Okay, and you don't have to buy shoulder pads. Do
exactly.
You still do that?
Or you could still do that. Okay. Like a little booster.
Yeah.
A little booster, why not? So for this one, we're gonna bring our dumbbells in front of us. And I have about 5, she has 2.
20, I have 20.
Sometimes. And then we're gonna bring that up to the eyebrow. So you wanna find those eyebrows and bring that up and you wanna hold and squeeze the shoulder. That's what's gonna make this exercise work. It's actually squeezing the muscle. Now we're gonna come out to the side.
Okay.
Bring it to the front, up to that eyebrow. Resist down. Up to the side and hold, resist down. Up to the front and hold, resist down. Okay. That holding is what makes this workout work its magic.
How many reps should we be doing?
Should try to do like 10 to 15, but the thing is that you should bring those weights up. So, you know what I mean? Like, if this becomes easy and you're popping out 15 of these, like, no problem, grab the 10s.
Okay.
Grab the 12s. Grab the 20s.
Okay.
Make it happen. Okay, last exercise. We're gonna bring it down here. We're gonna bring it to a bicep. Then we're gonna push, press, bring it back down. So this is a bicep and a shoulder, all into one.
Okay.
Ready?
Yeah.
We're gonna pop it, up, pop it, and down.
I'm swinging. I can't
swing.
Don't swing.
Huh? Try to keep it nice and controlled. But this is going to give you the arm and that shoulder for that smaller waist.
Should you be tightening your arms this whole time or
you
just trying to lift?
You shouldn't lock them.
Okay.
So don't like lock your elbow, but definitely have a nice flow. A nice flow that goes.
Okay. Do you have one more quick move for like these tries?
Triceps. Okay.
Yeah.
So we're going to do a nice little kickback. Elbows in locked, straight back. So a lot of people swing their arms when they do this.
Me.
You want to make sure that you have your arms all the way back. Keep those elbows locked. Back. Bring it on back, girl. Bring it back.
Am I doing
it? Oh,
cool.
Yeah.
There.
So there you go. There's some simple moves that you can do at home. Just grab some dumbbells. If you don't have these, grab some cans.
Cool. How much is a can? Like 1.5 pounds? Like a soup can, maybe?
Yeah, soup can works if that's what you have.
Okay.
That works.
Well, thank you. I already feel tighter and toner.
Perfect.
I appreciate it. Well, stick around, guys. We'll be right back. Also, make sure to tune in tomorrow. I'll be live at Magic Fashion Convention, bringing you a sneak peek at the trends to look out for this year. Plus, Kendall gets some performance pointers from Cirque du Soleil. And we've got a new adorable, adoptable friend joining us in studio.
San Diego's historic Hotel del Coronado is proud to be the home of the ghost of Kate Morgan.
Ghost?
Yes, she lives in room 220.
International calling to Mexico and other countries. No contract for just $89.99 a month with free pro install and HD receiver included. Switch today.
How was your workout?
It was good. Yeah. I should have put my blazer back on. So unprofesh.
But you have a good excuse. You were working out.
Yeah, there's good tips.
Yeah.
It was good. Well, guys, welcome back. Our 5 o'clock news starts here in a few minutes. Denise Valdez is standing by with a look at what's ahead.
Hi there, you two. Skill-based gaming and esports tournaments. These are just a couple of the different ways casinos are helping to attract millennial gamers. Paul Johnsich explains why you may soon see some changes to casino floors. And if you are allergic to gluten, you likely are going to rely on food labels when making your grocery store purchases. But as consumer advocate Michelle Mortensen explains, they can't always be trusted. And more than 2 feet of snow in some areas up on Mount Charleston over the weekend. Great news for skiers, but it did make for a close call for one residential neighborhood who was almost hit by an avalanche. Meteorologist Katie Bohrer will join us live on the mountain with the latest. Meantime, though, Tedd is over at Las Vegas now, where he's going to tell us about our soggy, soggy weekend and any other changes we've got for this coming week. Tedd?
Yeah, that's right, guys. First, though, I think I lost some weight just watching Lindsey work out.
That's good.
Just how it works, right?
Yeah, vicariously, you can burn calories.
I was like, keep going. Lindsey, keep going.
I need to burn
10 more pounds. Thank you. All right, we want to take a look at our forecast, of course, tonight. We've got some wind to deal with, partly cloudy skies, some breezes tonight. They will decrease down to single digits by late night tonight. Now, tomorrow, a different story. Partly cloudy and gusty winds. We could see gusts up to 35. There are wind advisories for the mountains out towards Prump, Amargosa Valley, and Lincoln County. Here is your extended forecast. Now, still breezy on Wednesday and Thursday. We go into 70s tomorrow and get this, guys, back down to the high 50s only by the end of the week, and stay in those 50s also for next week, too. I'm just the messenger, just so you know.
I don't think anybody holds it against you.
Good. That's great. No. Yeah.
But I blame you for the rain all last. I blame you for the rain.
Really? Yeah. I love the rain. The rain was, we needed
it. No, I was like, Tedd, come on.
I think I heard her, actually.
Come on.
That was you.
Yeah, that was me. All right, guys. Well, when you're tired of waiting, you're just tired of waiting. Check out this cute, hilarious video of a dog who's clearly had enough.
I love that he doesn't bother barking.
That was me in the car when it rained.
Barking,
I was like, Tedd, come on. That is Diamond. His owner stopped at a Subway to get a quick bite to eat, and although she was only here for just 2 minutes,
that's great.
Diamond was seen honking the horn and barking. Yeah, she had it.
Apparently Diamond is pretty popular, or at least well known. I don't know how popular
this particular
Diamond would
dog?
Be. Yeah. Yeah, and around Ohio, because once these videos started going around on the internet, a lot of people said, oh, yeah, I've seen Diamond honking around town.
Oh,
really?
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Yes. It might get annoying if you lived next door to Diamond and Diamond was often in the car.
Yeah, and also, why are you leaving your dog in your car alone so much?
That's
around
the
town?
Next part of the story.
Thanks for joining us. We really appreciate it. We'll see you back here tomorrow.
I'm doing stuff with Cirque tomorrow?
Yeah, they're going to
I had no idea. I didn't even know.
I'm looking forward to it. Nice. Better you.